try to apa make the okay apa consider lah make the consideration the point have been given. Some cases they will give you okay some example normally they will give you sigma. Some cases they will give you okay imaginary point depend because of to answer the one question is 30 minutes. So kalau kita if we follow all the step, okay, we will take more than 30 minutes. So that's why they try to skip, make you they will try to make you easy to come up with your locus. And then dia bagilah kan, ada dia yang bagi. Kalau if the question is straightforward, means they're not given anything. So but now if you can see here, we have orders 4 power s power of 4 means heavy plan ataupun heavy system. So dia akan bagi ya. Kalau if you looking for roof array, okay, to implementation of roof array s power of 4, it take time, maybe it will take 10 or 12 minutes something. Jadi susahlah bila nak siap gambar raja. So jadi tu yang dia bagi tu, dia terus bagi. Dia tak payah buat lah, we dah skip lah. We skip rule 9. Bila macam tu lah, kena hati-hati, kena tengok. Nanti saya bagi lagi soalan dalam group. At least awak ada satu gambaran. Oh, okay lah. So jangan stress, relax. Tak faham tanya. Ini sebab tak dalam paper graph ni. Okey kelas, dah ada soalan lagi tak? Kita bincang jawapan kelas, ada tolong tanya. Saya tak suka tanya last minute. Nanti malam esok nak exam, hari ni baru nak tanya. Tak, saya tak susah, saya tak layan sangat ah. Susah sikit. Okey, anyone ada soalan lagi selain pada okey, Abdul Rahman, are you finish?
Doktor.
Ya. Yeah.
Ya.
Yeah. Yang angle departure tu.
Ya. Yeah.
180 tolak summation delta apa ni? Tetapi minus delta z eh.
Betul.
Oh, jadi maksudnya 180 tolak 108.43 tolak 45 dapat 26.57 eh.
Betul.
Oh, sebab saya tambahkan.
Boleh. Dia macam ni, dia ada juga, dia ada negative summation of delta campur dengan 180. Boleh.
Patutlah dapat 26.57. Sepatutlah saya tak dapat 26.57. Sebelik.
Dia kena cakap tapi yang make sure ada
buka tu lah. Saya boleh daripada masa tu.
Satu tutup salah satu nanti awak ada interak ni. Dengar suara tu.
Okay.
Boleh? Okay. So kita discuss eh. Ni this is the Taufik answer. Okay. Boleh Taufik saya share eh?
Boleh Doktor.
Okay baik. Okay. Mana pula dah? Oh. Okay, so now so we have this diagram where we have G and also H, and we also have K, so mean K, G and H. So from this open loop transfer function, we have K, G, H equal to, so kita copy balik lah, we just multiply je lah. Sorry. So we have S plus 2, so H equal to 1, so tak ada masalah, we don't have any problem. So we have S plus 4, then we have S plus 2, S plus 2. Okay, selesai, finish. So now this is number root 1, so we identify the value of pool and 0. So we have 0, negative 2. And pool negative 1, negative 4, and then we need to come up with imaginary point. So we have 4 here. So number of pools 4, number of 0, 1. Okay, selesai. So now we're looking for asymptote. Okay, so once you finish this identification of the point, so you need to use the paper graph lah. Lepas tu buat dalam paper graph. So mark to the paper graph. We have real, imaginary. Okay, what we have here, we have negative 1 here. Saya buat kali lagi. So we have negative 1. And then we have 2. And then we have negative 4, negative 3 and 4 here. And then we have 1, 1 here. Kita buat kita graph. You need to use kita graph to make your accurate get the accurate value. So jadi now we have apa ni? We have 5 point in the S plane. Okay, so from here we need to come up with the angle asymptote. So this is the formula 2k plus 1. Multiply 180 over P minus Z. So from here we will get here, and then we have 3 angle 60 180 300. Okay, so now we're looking for CG. So this is the CG ni, kita ada CG ni. So okay, the point is CG is okay is in at negative 1 6 7, so it's around here lah. Yes, around here. So jadi use your projector, carilah projector, jadi katalah projector, try to use projector 60 degree to fit. This is around here lah kat sini. Sini katalah 60 180 300. See what we did previous example, standard je tu. Nanti awak akan nampak dia punya apa dia panggil, dia punya tu sama je, dia punya trend dia tu sama. Okay, so finish. Then okay, satu lagi align. Okay, we need to put align will be appear in the odd number. So from here, real number, we only have 3 point, which is this is number 1, number 2 and number 3. So number 1 left here. Number 2 no, number 3 yes. So align until end. So we have arrow, we have arrow. Okay, if you can see here, kalau kita lihat kat sini, we don't have any pool and pull. So we only have Okay, pull 0 and then pull. So basically we don't have any breakpoint. So that's why you no need to find breakpoint. Tak ada, tak sesuai, not suitable for this case. So jadi kalau kena ingat, if you okay, if we have, kalau katalah we have apa, pull and pull, we have arrow and arrow, so they were somewhere. We have the breakpoint. So barulah kita ada breakpoint, you need to find sigma B and then make sure they will break into the 90 and negative 90 degree. So and then they will follow ataupun they will approach the asymptote. Tapi now our case we don't have any breakpoint. So no need, tak payah. Okay. So selesai, finish. Now we looking for delta D. Okay, delta D. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, delta D. Saya buat macam ni lah. Saya buat satu lagi. Bagi nampak clear sikit. Okay, sekejap eh. Okay, katalah kita buat macam mana. Kita buat.
Doktor, saya nak tanya.
Ya, yeah, boleh.
Bila je nak guna line tu? Between apa tadi?
Adalah macam-macam, dia pakai locus axis lah, Lucy lah. Jadi saya panggil line je.
Saya tak faham bila nak letak line tu, bila tak payah letak line tu.
Bila nak letak, bila letak macam ni. Kena tengok dulu, dia tak boleh hafal, you cannot remember. Maksudnya you need to understand. Okay, dia macam ni lah. Contoh eh. Okay, we have this pool, pool, zero, pool, zero. Contoh. Okay, so a line. So, ni a line. Because of number one, number two, number three, number four, number five. Number not value, number. Okay, so number one, odd. It will go to left. Maksudnya a line will be appear in left. Two, three, left. 4, 5, left. So, this one is, we have arrow, and we arrow. Kalau if we have this, apa, this two pool, okay, it will go to, atau maksudnya dia akan ada. They will have the breakpoint. Kalau ni, tak ada. Tak ada eh, okay. Kena tengok jugalah, saya tak boleh hafal sangat. Tapi kalau kata if we have, for example eh, so we have here. Here, katakanlah here. So, okay, our okay, left 1, 2, 3 left. Okay, 4, 5 left. Betul. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. So we have this, we have this. So here also have, and also here also have. Sebab selalunya normally we have face to face by pool. Kalau kita ada jumpa pertemuan tu antara in between pool and pool, it will go they will have the sigma B ataupun sigma P. Boleh?
Oh, okay, sorry. So macam selang-seli lah.
Ya, selang. Dia bukan selang-seli lah. Dia oh, kena buat latihan lagi. Nanti saya bagi lagi. Selalunya dia akan jumpa pool dan pool.
Okay, kalau macam apa ni, pole dengan pole ada break point kan? Kalau macam zero dengan
zero tak ada.
Oh, zero tak ada.
Tak ada. Kalau katalah zero kan, kata sini kan, jarang kalau zero ni dia tak, kalau dalam sistem dia tak menggambarkan apa-apa sangat, dia tak penting sangat. Ya, katalah zero here lah. We have this zero. Zero. Boleh lah. Tapi tak, jarang jumpa lah. Tak akan ada. Okay, 1, 2, 3. So, we have this. And then we have this. Okay, ada. Kalau if. Tapi selalunya jarang. Ada. Kalau ni. So, zero is menerima. Maksudnya zero is to receive the locus. So for example here, you can see here this pole, okay, will be attract 2D ataupun will be transfer all this Lucy to D0. Maksud dia menerima. So some cases, kalau some cases ada. Ada bermaksud katalah kita ada, we have this ni Okay, ada. Tapi jarang berlaku lah. Okay, jarang berlaku. Kalau we have this, okay, we have pull and pull. We know that, okay, this is our arrow, this is our line route, our locus, and this is our locus. So what happen, kalau awak kira betul-betul nanti kan, katakanlah, it will go somewhere the way somewhere, nanti awak akan kira nanti dia akan pergi sini. Dia akan pergi sini. So maksudnya dia keluar, nanti dia masuk. Selalu, tapi jarang lah. Nah, yang ni buat master lah. Okay, dia sistem ni unik sikit. Tapi dia takkan dera lah untuk degree. Tak payah fikir pelik-pelik. Tapi nak tunjuk contoh, I will give you some example this. If you have pull and pull, then zero, pull and pull, it will go like this. Maksud dia akan jumpa macam ni. Macam mana pengiraan tu, ada pengiraan dia. Tapi kita tak ada syllabus semacam ni. Sebab you will sketch in software MATLAB. Nanti bila nak buat MATLAB dalam hari Khamis nanti. Ya, Thursday I will show how to draw root locus in MATLAB ataupun optive. Boleh, tak ada masalah. Boleh ni Kalau pull and pull, and we have 0 and 0, pull and pull, it will go thing. Sebab if we jarang lah, susah lah jumpa, very difficult to find if we have pool, 0 and 0, jarang. Okay, tak apa, kita fokus yang ni dulu. Okay, so jadi now we have negative 1, saya buat tinggi sikit. Negative 1, here, negative 1, negative 1, positive, negative, and then we have 2, 3 and 4. Okay, so now we have here. Here. Nak cari ni, delta D ni. Ni tak ada, tak payah nak pandang lah. Kalau tak pun boleh buat menerima, tak ada masalah. So now kita punya, we have apa? Okay. So, okay. Nak cari delta D. So we take one point as a reference. This is our reference So you make a line, maksudnya ambil light a line lah, ambil nipis je line dia. So ambil negative 1 ni a line because we have 1 and 2, and then we have a line, we have 0, and then we have pull. Okay, pull. So now here this is delta 1. This is delta 2, this is delta 3, this one is delta 4. Okay, so kita kira cari lah ni. Awak kena cari. So, you should cari dia. Okay, delta ni maksudnya. So, our formula delta D is equal to. So, we have negative delta plus 180. So, now. We concentrate on delta dulu. Delta saja. One apa? One ni. Okay. So, okay, we try to concentrate on the delta. Delta saja. So, our delta is, okay, our delta now positive 1 plus we have positive 2, delta 2, negative delta t because of 0. Plus delta 4. Nanti awak akan dapat. Okay. Then selesai dapat ni. Katalah ni adalah apa kita nak buat. Katalah N. Ya.
Kenapa delta 3 negatif?
Negatif 3. Delta 3 negatif. Because of dia refer to the 0. Pull is positive. 0 is negative. Boleh tak? Ni konsep dia.
Pull.
Okay, the angle of pull is representing is positive. The angle of zero is representing is negative. dia kena tolak.
So why theta 4 is positive?
Wait. Astaghfirullahaladzim. Ni, sorry, Abdul Rahman. This is pool.
Oh, okay.
Okay, negative 4. Sorry, eh? Abdul Rahman?
Yeah, okay.
Okay. Sorry. Okay, eh? Alright. So, now, kita ada M. So, M, so you got the total of the angle of M ni. Kalau refer to, apa tadi? Allah. Refer to ni soalan dia jawapan dia. Sekejap. Refer to mana tadi dah. Okay ni. Ni. Okay angle dia. Lebih kurang berapa lah Taufik tak nampak. So kita ada 90 because of. Okay alright. Faham saya faham. So jadinya ni Taufik dia you will get yang ni. Ni. And then we have this. 90 because of a line kan. So 90. So we have ni here. And then we have this. Ni because of we have 1. And 1 should be 45 ke? Berapa awak dapat Taufik?
Negative 65.
65 okay. Somewhere. So negative 65. This one. Berapa Taufik awak dapat? 35. It's around 35. So 35. So now. We have delta only 90 plus 90 minus 65 plus 35. So overall, berapa ni Fik? Lepas tu dapatlah nanti. Berapa ni? 180. Ini tolak ni 180 tolak 30. So 160 betul? Betul Fik? 150 means we have delta D is negative 150 plus 180. So we have 30 around lah. Kalau buat dalam, if you do in the paper graph, they will maybe you will get less lah. Tapi kalau tak, it's roughly 30. So 30 means okay, they will okay. Move to the 30 degree. So apa kita nak buat? So kalau kita zoom ni okay, this is your asymptote, this is okay 30 degree. So 30 degree is around here lah lebih kurang sini. So apa kita buat then you go boom ni you akan keluar kat sini, dia akan pintas kat sini. So pintas dia, dia will cross over tu berapa? So cari dia will, okay our equation, mana equation kita dah lupa dah. Okay here negative 2.53. So negative 2.53 mana pula? It's around ni lah, maksudnya 2.3 ni 1, maybe 2 here. So mean they will go somewhere lah. Ni pun tak ikut scale. So tak boleh. So they will go to here and then they will go to here. Ni make sure that kita punya point ni is 2.53J and negative 2.53J. Nah? Okay. Dapat ni. Boleh lah?
Jadi yang contoh minggu lepas tu yang dia ke bawah tu sebab dia angle
ke bawah. Ya yeah, betul. Ke bawah ni sebab apa? Sebab bawah ni kalau macam ni contoh kan. Ke bawah ni macam nak panggil eh. Okey, ke bawah ni kebetulan okey katalah ni sorry. Ini kita punya asymptote. We have this asymptote. This is our katalah this is our ni. Okay, because of kalau sebab apa? Sebab dia kat bawah ni. Dia punya asymptote yang asymptote sepadan kat bawah tu yang dia akan bawa pergi sini. Kalau yang case ni, our case just now, asymptote ni kat atas. Dia 60. So bila 60 tu dia terus naik atas. Dia terus. Ni salah. Ni tak tepat lah sebab kita buat bukan ni kan. Apa? Bukan angle, bukan scale. Kalau ikutkan scale, this is one should be here one. Yang ni baru dua. Macam tu lah. Kena buat skill. You need to do in graph paper graph. Ha, kena buat dalam kertas paper ke dalam kertas graf. Baru nampak nanti. Tu pun kadang-kadang depend juga. Tapi kurang-kurangnya awak dapat lah. Sebab nanti awak nak kira apa tau. Okay, after you finish this. Okay, after you finish ni. Let's say you finish. Okay, for the examination is they will ask you to to answer this. Yeah, number 2 ni. Okay, they want us to identify ataupun estimate the value of T, time constant, okay, and K. If we have zeta is 0.5. So zeta is 0.5. Okay, apa kita nak buat ni tak payah lagi. Kita tengok contoh yang ni, yang basic. Okay. Now, for example, now this is your figure. S plane. So this is the real, this is imaginary. Okay. We have, now we have this. And we have this, katalah yang tadi just now, we have this. And also we have this. Okay. So you have done for Lucy. We have done for Lucy. Okay. And then this is your asymptote, katalah. This is your asymptote is around 1 point, lebih kurang lah eh. Dia 1.7 sini. Sikit je tak apa, biar dulu. We have this. 300 is around this. Okay. So from here you will get this. Katalah. Saya kecil kan. You will get this. Okay. Now from here, okay, this is the root locus system, root locus diagram. So in this case, after this, you will define, the damping ratio. So damping. Ratio. Okay, from this sketching root locus, okay, you can design your model ataupun you can estimate the behavior of this system and also to get the value of damping ratio, natural frequency, okay, natural frequency FERQ, okay. You will get natural frequency EWN. And then we have damping ratio. Damps natural frequency. WD. WD. Time constant. T. Okay. From this root locus. So. Okay, what we can do now, apa yang kita nak buat adalah normally they will give us the sudut lah. They will give the one extra sudut we call beta. Ni ada beta. Beta ni it represent as the reference juga. So kalau dia bagi delta ni, apa kita buat adalah okay, delta ni, okay, katalah delta, nanti kita katalah 60 degree. So di 60 degree we have cos beta. So jadi sekarang ni 60 degree, apa kita nak buat adalah this beta is represent. Nanti kita akan belajar benda ni. Tapi saya tunjuk dulu. So this beta is here. It's around here. Katalah 60 degree. So ambil pembaris banyak lagi ni. Benda ni nanti awak nak kena lukis. So jadi ambil 60 degree ni. Sorry eh. I'm not good. I'm sketching. Okay. Here is beta. Beta. Okay. Once you align beta is 60 degree, whatever degree. Okay. Put a line here. Means, okay, apa yang akan berlaku adalah you can calculate all these things. Maksudnya WN, WD. Kena cari dulu delta ni. Atau some tengoklah point mana. Jadi apa yang akan berlaku adalah okay, once you get this line, okay, apa kita buat adalah you will get this. Dapat yang this intersection, you will get this. Okay, this point, this imaginary point, it, okay, it represent as WD, WD, damped natural frequency. And then this intersection point to exist, to real exist here, it's represent as, ini, is represent as zeta WN equal to 1 over T. T. Bermaksud nanti kalau kata graf ni nanti, okay, if you apa design in the paper graph, you will get the exact value based on the unit, based on 1 unit or 1 cm. And then you get, katalah here is 0, maybe 0.8. Then 0.8 is equal to 1 over T. And T is 1, T is the 1 over 1.8. So you will get value of T. So zeta dia just now, in our case, dia dah bagi kan nilai zeta kan. So jadi kita dah boleh cari zeta kat sini. And then kita akan manipulate benda ni. So jadi sekarang ni, in case, in this case, kita nak cari WD based on our intersection beta ni. Nanti nanti saya akan tunjuk contoh lain. So once you have this, I go to align real axis ni, you will get this formula. Only one. Tu sebab tu paper graph penting. So jadi ni you will get this apa, this value is represent as zeta WN equal to 1 over T equal to this point. And also this WD is represent as value of WD. You, okay, once you get WD, you will get WN easily. Okay, for example now, okay, what the formula of W related to WN and WD class? Ingat lah, tak ingat lagi tak apa. So we have WD is equal to, we have WN root of 1 zeta square. Okay, so now for in this case, okay, if you can see, okay, based on our result, sorry, based on our equation, okay, they given us zeta equal to 0.5. So they want us to find value of T and value of K. Okay, based on our ni, okay, our discussion just now, we have this, okay, this is the our root locus sketch. So we have this, okay, now we have zeta WN and WD. So WD they will give, tapi dia tak bagi kita beta. Dia tak bagi beta. Kalau dia tak bagi beta, WN, WD, WN. Kita tak bagi zeta. Okay, sebab apa? Because of, okay, now, okay, dia ada lagi relationship dia. Sekejap, saya tulis kat sini. Okay, saya tulis kat sini. Okay, relationship adalah zeta is equal to cos beta. So now 0.5, here 0.5 cos beta. So now beta is what degree? Maksudnya nanti inverse cos ni. So our beta is around Allah, tak boleh tulis kan. Okay, beta is around 60 degree lah. So 60 degree. So jadi apa kita nak buat? Use your projector, put the 60 degree here and then cross to the our line here. Bila cross to our line here, okay, you will get WD here. This is the value of WD and this is the value of 1 over T. Ataupun kalau tak nak, you can use this formula to define the WN. So jadi sama juga, then equal to 1 over T. So kita akan dapat lah nilai WT. We will get the 1 over T. We will get the value of T. And, okay, and, okay, and the question ask us to define K. K, ada lagi K. So lagi ada lagi K. So jangan stress, relax dulu. Awak tengok dulu, you just lihat dulu apa yang akan berlaku. Kejap okay. K ni apa? In just in one graph, tu kena hati-hati. In just one graph, you cannot make 2 or 3 graph. Just dalam satu graph ni awak kena buat tunjuk semua dalam tu. Okay. Jadi apa kita nak buat adalah, so this is your angle, this is your, this is, ya, saya repeat balik, I will repeat again that drawing. Okay, so now we have this somewhere here, you have somewhere here, you have somewhere here, you have somewhere here. Okay, so beta you have done. Beta, for example, here. Beta, this is beta, 60 degree. So, beta here. Katalah, this is beta. This is your beta. Beta, eh? 60 degree. Okay, now K. K, K, eh? K. So, our, okay, jap. Our system, our transformation is KGH equal to, we have S plus 2 just now, we have S plus 1, we have S plus 4, and we have S plus 1 plus J, and also we have S plus, sorry, plus, I don't know, plus 1 negative J. Okay. So, jadi ni eh. Okay. Apa kita nak buat adalah, okay, to define the K, ni kita nak cari ni ni. We are looking for value of K now. Okay, the formula of 2, okay, to looking for value of K, we need to KGH modulus is equal to 1, equal to, so we have K, S plus 2, S plus 2, so ni semua modulus nanti tau, okay, so we have S plus 1, S plus 4, S plus 1 plus J, modulus S plus 1 negative J. Okay, so we need to, okay, we need to define ataupun calculate di apa ni, panjang, bukan panjang. We need to define the range of this S plus 1, S plus 4, S plus 1 plus J, S plus 1 negative J, and S plus 2. Okay, where, how? Based on this intersection. Kita dah dapat kan, 60 degree for beta, because of our zeta is equal to cos beta. So we have 0.5 cos beta, means our beta is 60 degree. So, we based on our projector, 60 degree, then you will get this cross. Maksudnya ada intersection between a line beta in, between this line beta and this line. Maksudnya our root line ni. Okay, now, apa kita nak buat adalah, you need to align. Okay, align based on this reference. We have four pole and 1, 0. So, buat apa? Nanti you come out with align this. This align, this cross to this point. Pull line. Ambil satu line ni. Cari. Ambil pembaris, but because of we use one unit is one point. Means that this is one unit, 1 cm. So ambil pembaris betul-betul, check. Okay, this is what? This is a line of S plus 1 plus J. Okay, ambil ni, use this, put your roller, masuk ni, refer to your roller, this line. This line is represent as S plus 1 line. So, ambil this, align this, align this point to, intersection to this point. This is S plus 1 minus J. Align number dia. So ambil ni, align here. This one and this one is S plus 2. Align. Jarak dia. Ambil jarak ni. And S plus 4. Sorry. Plus 4. So here. So now, okay, saya kecilkan sikit. Apa kita nak dapat? Kita dah dapat dah line ni. we have line here. So jadi okay, substitute to the our our formula. So our formula is 1 equal to k. K, so how much range? S plus 2. Ni S plus 2. Ambil pembaris ni, use your ruler, measure from this intersection to this intersection. So let's say this is A. This is value A. So you put, you get the value A. And then we have S plus 1. So here is, use your ruler, measure, and then you will get value of this. Maybe here I assume as B. Okay. And then C. C is S plus 4. S plus 4 here. So use your ruler to measure this point to this point. You will get the range of this point. This I assume as C. And then for D, S plus 1J is very small here. Maksudnya ni, masih dapat ni, I will assume as a D. So I put here D. And then lastly, I will get this point to this point as D, E. E. Okay. And then you will have, you have point, you have point value, you have value, you have value, you have value, and you have value. Lastly, you will calculate. And you will get the value of K. Awak akan dapat nilai K yang sebenar. The real K in this system. Ada soalan tak? Mesti confused. Tapi tak apa. Soalan kelas. Ada soalan?
Doktor, saya nak tanya pasal yang point untuk imaginary tadi.
Boleh, boleh. Okay.
Kan dia bagi point untuk imaginary. So, untuk plot dekat dalam kertas graf kena kira okay, ikut point tu ke?
Ya, yeah, ikut point tu. Refer to point tu. Maksudnya terus tick positive 2.53 dengan negative 2.3 tu, ambil terus layan.
Oh, okay, okay, faham. Sebab tadi saya lukis je, tak ikut point.
Awak kena buat. Yang tu awak kena lukis. You need to follow nah instruction.
Macam mana, Doktor? 2.53?
Ya, yeah, apa dia?
Yang 2.53 tu macam mana?
Macam mana macam ni? Sekarang ni, sekejap saya lukis. Sekarang ni kan, saya besarkan sikit. Okay. Sekarang ni katalah this is 1, this is 2J, 1J. Tak best lah. Sekejap. Saya buat ni macam tak bagus ni. Sekejap ni saya buat lagi. Sekejap ni. Sekejap saya buat sikit. Kita buat macam kita buat sikit. Katalah macam ni. Kita panjangkan sikit. Kita panjangkan sikit. Okay, sekarang ni adalah 1J. This is J. This is 2J. This is negative J. This is negative 2J. Negative 2J. Nah, negative 2J. This is number 1. Okay, this is yours. 1. This is yours. Ni. 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 Okay. Jadi sekarang ni asymptote here. This go to katalah here. Ni pun tak kena ni sebab I will not follow the scale. Tapi I'll give you the nilai. Okay. Apa gambaran figure. Visually apa okay, imaginary. Okay, so now we have this. Sama eh. So apa yang kita nak buat, okay, you count ataupun you tick 2.5. Let's say this is 3. Okay, so 2.53. So around here, betul? Setuju? This 2.53. This is negative 2.53. Okay, now your locus ni, okay, ni delta D is 26. It's around here lah. Kalau 26 ni, dia akan keluar macam tu lah katalah. Here, 26. Itulah, keluar je lah. Tak ada masalah lah. Okay, then it will go to here and then terus passing je. Tak ada masalah guna, tak payah guna ruler. You just come up with free your free hand. Yeah, here. And then, ini negative 26. It will go somewhere. sama sini lah. Okey. Boleh? Faham tak? Pelan?
Faham tak?
Okey. So lepas je. Maksudnya jangan jangan garis lagi. Cari dulu point. Lepas tu baru passing. You need to define ataupun apa identify intersection point, then baru you come up with the draw, sketching line ni. Okay, so jangan. Selalunya kita akan buat dulu line ni. Kita dah nampak dah dia keluar kat mana, keluar dulu. Tapi nanti salah. Salah bukan apa sebab dia punya point tu lari. Tu pun tengok jugalah pada ni lah keadaan. Tengok jugalah benda ni. Tapi kena buat latihan. Ya, ada soalan kita?
Doktor?
Ya.
Saya nak tanya yang dia yang sketching line tu kan. Kita actually kita tengok pada intersection point baru boleh tahu dia ke arah mana ke?
Ya, betul, betul. You need to identify ataupun estimate the value intersection point first.
Okay, okay. Lepas tu dia doktor dia jadi berbalik pada soal dia yang Taufik sebelum ni. Kan yang sebelum, kan yang the previous exercise yang kita buat, kan yang sketching line tu kan dia curve kan? Dia lah punya straight line. Okay, yeah. Tu macam mana nak tahu?
Curve tu depend pada delta D ya. Delta D. Delta D ni apa? Positif ke negatif angle? So kalau negatif, barulah nanti dia macam tu lah. Kalau positif, dia just straight away ya. Kan kalau negatif, katalah we will, katalah kita dapat negatif 26 lah. So from here 26 is sini lah kan? Yeah. So jadi kita akan ambil daripada sini, kita balik cekok ni lah. Macam mata kail lah. Tapi dalam kes kita ni positif 26, kita just throw macam tu je. Boleh tak?
Father.
Ya, betul. Baik. Okey, lain? Abdul Rahman.
So doktor, kalau dia positif angle, tak payah dekatkan dia dengan asymptote contoh.
Ya, depend dia macam ni. Kalau kalau theoretical, maksudnya kalau based on kata kita nak buat real sketching, you need to identify angle dulu. Okay, because of this angle will be represent as the apa signal keluar tu, positif ke negatif, nak macam ni ke nak macam ni, maksudnya nak macam ni ke mungkin macam ni ke ataupun terus ke, tu satu. Once you okay define delta D, then jangan lagi buat lagi benda ni. Okay, jangan lagi buat benda ni. Kena cari dulu, use your ruler ataupun by your free hand to put a line ni. Jangan lagi, don't, you need to identify this angle, this intersection point dulu by using roof array ni. Kan, S square equal to blah blah blah, then barulah you friend. Tapi, if we have this example, kalau katalah we have this example, so we have we have this and we have this and we have this. Okay, we have 4 point in on the real line. So we have this and we have this. Okay, so easy lah. So katalah if we have this, okay, katalah kita dah dapat ni, kita dapat asymptote. So this is our asymptote. So we have negative 45, positive 135, 225, 315, katalah. Okay, this is our asymptote. Now, okay, you need to define sigma B first because of we have pull and pull. Then you identify, okay, you will get this point and then you will, okay, you will do a line. Okay, do a line here. Kalau kita buat line ni, make sure that, okay, they will break to the line is 90 degree positive, 90 degree negative. And then yang ni is okay. Yang ni is you just follow the asymptote. Maksudnya you put the line tegak and then follow the close to the asymptote. Ni tak ada masalah. Ni doesn't matter. Ni tak ada masalah. Katalah we have this also. We have pull and pull. Then okay. You just find the sigma B. And then just put line. Sampai sini ya, ataupun sampai kat sini, jangan lagi bengkok, come up with this intersection dulu. Kan, selalunya kita sampai sini, kita dah gairah dah kita nak buat. Padahal tengok point dia kat sini ke kat sini. Jadi nak kena bauter balik. Jadi what happen now, you need to okay consider ni dulu. Kalau if we have close to imaginary case, you need to find this. You need to find this. Kalau far from the imaginary point, imaginary exists, then tak ada masalah. You just follow on the line ataupun on the line asymptote. Kena tengok. Tapi some case, apa-apa pun kena tengok dulu asymptote juga. Some case, we have this. A point. So this is imaginary, sama, real. And then we know, okay, the asymptote is sama, some cases, the way asymptote is ni. Positive 90, 270. So here, so this cross. Okay, so tak ada masalah. You just align until infinity. So 90 degree lagi. Tak ada apa dah. Dia not go cross to apa. Ada juga. Nanti awak akan tengok you will face several problem. It's like macam-macam lah, anything it will happen because it depend on our model. Our model lah. Okay. So kena hati-hati kat sini. So be careful. So today we concentrate on figure and also this. To define T and WD based on our zeta damping ratio. From the our zeta you will get beta. And then from the beta, you will get the angle, cross to the angle. And then intersection of this crossing line ni, you will get value of K. Value of K ni. So, value of K based on our range. Between our intersection point, K beta to the our point pole and zero. It depends. So jadi kat sini awak kena kira ni. So final you will calculate all the detail. For the test 2, I think you only design until rule 9. Rule 9 lah, tak ada lagi design ni kot saya rasa. Tak tahu lagi, soalan tak ada lagi. We don't have any clue for test 2 yet. Ada soalan tak kelas?
Doktor, when is test 2?
Test 2, I also don't know. Nanti petang, this afternoon we have meeting. So I will try to inform you as soon as possible. I think maybe now, minggu berapa ni? Week berapa? What week now? 20K. First February is exam, right? First February, you mean February you are examination 2014, so now, I think maybe more than two, I mean next 2 weeks or next 3 weeks. Next 2 weeks lah, I think. Next 2 weeks. Test 2. Next 2 weeks. Cepat. Apa dia tadi? Lupa tadi. Siapa cakap ni?
Tak ada.
Okay. Saya rasa lebih kurang 2 minggu lagi. After next 2 week you will face test 2. This week no. Next 2 week no. I think next 2 week because of normally 1 week before final project presentation. Final project presentation is 29 to 30 January. So around before that week. Selalunya sebelum minggu tu lah. Minggu tu awak akan ada ujian. Banyak ujian, you will face a lot of your subject. Jadi be careful. So now you train to get sketching on the paper, road locus. Because road locus, it will take time to get the sketching, analysis and so on. So if you don't understand some cases, you are not use ataupun you will not define the sigma b, but you will calculate. Itu rugi lah maksudnya. Padahal benda tu tak payah tulis, tak payah lukis, tapi awak lukis. Tapi tak apalah, kurang-kurangnya sekarang awak dah tahu. Okay. Boleh? So okay, so jadi I will see you on Thursday. Hari Khamis insyaAllah. Okay, masih banyak-banyak. Selamat lambat bagi link.
Thank you,
Doctor. Thank you, Doctor.
Thank you, Doctor.